Imagine standing in the midst of a landscape sprawling infinitely in every direction. In your hand, you clutch a compass, an instrument typically tasked with pointing north, providing guidance and orientation. However, this compass defies the usual physical laws. Its needle doesn't seek magnetic north, but instead swivels with purpose towards a direction that's not on any map, a direction leading you toward a higher calling, a deeper communion with the divine. This compass is more than a navigator, it is a metaphor, a representation of the inner voice, the soul's longing to find its way back to its creator. It is the innate desire that stirs within each of us, a yearning to connect with God, to tap into a relationship that transcends the tangible and enters the realm of the spiritual. As the needle of this compass moves, it is sensitive to the changing winds of our lives, our trials, tribulations, joys, and sorrows. These winds can shift suddenly, urging us to follow the compass's guidance promptly. The journey it proposes is one of profound spiritual treasures, a path that promises to lead us to the essence of our faith, our purpose, and ultimately, our salvation. This compass, then, becomes a powerful symbol of our spiritual journey. It acknowledges that while there are many directions one might take in life, the path towards God is the one that offers true significance. It calls for immediate action. For the window to follow this unique compass is narrow, and once closed, it may not present itself again. Therefore, let us embrace this moment with fervor, putting God at the forefront of our lives. Let's be vigilant and responsive to the spiritual opportunities presented to us, for they are as ephemeral as a breath visible on a cold day. They're one moment and gone the next. We must grasp these chances with both hands before they slip away, for the pursuit of God's presence is the most worthwhile quest of all. In this spiritual journey, there is no final destination, no point at which we can say we have arrived. For those who have embarked on this sacred quest, know that it is an eternal pursuit. We must continue to seek God with steadfast devotion, for there is always more to learn, more room to grow closer, and further depths to explore in the boundless expanse of God's love and wisdom. With each step we take on this path, let us renew our pursuit with the urgency of our first steps, recognizing that every moment with God is ripe with the potential for greater revelation and transformation. The time to seek God is not tomorrow or at some convenient point in the future, it is now. Today presents a unique and irreplaceable opportunity to draw nearer to the divine. And we must act with the utmost immediacy, for tomorrow is promised to no one. With this compass in hand, let us begin our journey, guided by the seven reasons that underscore the necessity of seeking God at this moment. Each reason a beacon that illuminates our path ever closer to the loving embrace of our Creator and His boundless grace. In this critical juncture of self-realization, we confront the core truth of our existence, that life is an ephemeral mist, a transient journey that demands immediate attention to our spiritual compass. The metaphor of the compass extends into the urgency of the pursuit. It does not merely point to a direction, it implores us to move, to act, to journey forward without delay. The spiritual pursuit is not a leisurely stroll, but a call to swift action. Recognizing that the windows of opportunity are like the morning fog, present for a moment and then dissolved in the day's bright light. Just as the needle of the compass swings with intention, so must our will align with its direction, propelling us towards divine encounters and moments of profound spiritual awakening. This urgency is further accentuated by the fleeting nature of our earthly existence. We are reminded that time waits for no one, and the opportunities to grow closer to our Creator. To deepen our understanding and to enrich our spirits with divine wisdom are as precious as they are fleeting. The analogy of the compass's swift movement correlates with the rapid pace at which life unfolds, often leaving us with mere moments to make decisions that could define the trajectory of our souls. The journey towards spiritual enlightenment and communion with God is not to be postponed. The now is the only moment we truly own, the only moment wherein we can heed the call of our spiritual compass. As such, it is imperative that we grasp the urgency of this pursuit with every fiber of our being, anchoring our actions and decisions in the reality that the right time is the current moment. As we navigate the tumultuous seas of life, let this compass guide us to make God the priority in every decision, every action, every thought. It is in this immediate and fervent pursuit that we find the treasures of spirituality that are not bound by the constraints of time and space, treasures that bring eternal joy, peace, and the ultimate fulfillment of our spiritual quest. Thus, we are summoned not to hesitate, not to ponder the what-ifs, but to embrace the what-nows of our spiritual journey. The urgency is not one of panic or fear, but of a conscious and deliberate choice to prioritize our spiritual development as the foremost task at hand. In the grand tapestry of life, each thread is woven with the potential for spiritual growth, and it is our duty to recognize this potential and act upon it with urgency and passion. The compass in our hands is not just a guide, but a symbol of the dynamic and active nature of our faith, a faith that calls us to move, to seek, to love, and to live with an awareness that every moment is a stepping stone towards the divine. In this critical juncture of self-realization, we confront the core truth of our existence, that life is an ephemeral mist, a transient journey that demands immediate attention to our spiritual compass. The metaphor of the compass extends into the urgency of the pursuit. It does not merely point to a direction, it implores us to move, to act, to journey forward without delay. The spiritual pursuit is not a leisurely stroll, but a call to swift action. Recognizing that the windows of opportunity are like the morning fog, present for a moment and then dissolved in the day's bright light. Just as the needle of the compass swings with intention, so must our will align with its direction, propelling us towards divine encounters and moments of profound spiritual awakening. This urgency is further accentuated by the fleeting nature of our earthly existence. We are reminded that time waits for no one, and the opportunities to grow closer to our Creator, to deepen our understanding and to enrich our spirits with divine wisdom are as precious as they are fleeting. The analogy of the compass's swift movement correlates with the rapid pace at which life unfolds, often leaving us with mere moments to make decisions that could define the trajectory of our souls. The journey towards spiritual enlightenment and communion with God is not to be postponed. The now is the only moment we truly own, the only moment wherein we can heed the call of our spiritual compass. As such, it is imperative that we grasp the urgency of this pursuit with every fiber of our being, anchoring our actions and decisions in the reality that the right time is the current moment. As we navigate the tumultuous seas of life, let this compass guide us to make God the priority in every decision, every action, every thought. It is in this immediate and fervent pursuit that we find the treasures of spirituality that are not bound by the constraints of time and space, treasures that bring eternal joy, peace, and the ultimate fulfillment of our spiritual quest. Thus, we are summoned not to hesitate, not to ponder the what-ifs, but to embrace the what-nows of our spiritual journey. The urgency is not one of panic or fear, but of a conscious and deliberate choice to prioritize our spiritual development as the foremost task at hand. In the grand tapestry of life, each thread is woven with the potential for spiritual growth, and it is our duty to recognize this potential and act upon it with urgency and passion. The compass in our hands is not just a guide, but a symbol of the dynamic and active nature of our faith, a faith that calls us to move, to seek, to love, and to live with an awareness that every moment is a stepping stone towards the divine. The path of spiritual pursuit is not defined by a single moment of revelation or a solitary act of devotion. Rather, it is characterized by a continuous and evolving journey that stretches before us, beckoning us to tread further. Even when the initial spark of seeking God is settled into the steady flame of faith, this journey is lifelong and dynamic, reflecting the ever-changing tapestry of human experience. Those who have set foot on this path must understand that it is not a finite expedition, but an infinite exploration, a sacred passage that does not culminate in complacency, but calls for a persistent and unwavering commitment to growth and discovery in God's infinite love and wisdom. The quest for a deeper connection with the divine is not to be paused or placed on hold, but to be actively pursued each day with renewed vigor. The spiritual compass that once pointed us in the right direction now urges us to continue moving, to delve deeper into the mysteries and joys of our relationship with God. It is an invitation to cultivate a steadfast devotion, to nourish the seeds of faith that have been planted within our hearts, and to allow them to flourish. There is always room for growth, for the depth of God's nature is unfathomable, and the journey towards Him is limitless. The continuous spiritual journey is a process of becoming, of transforming ourselves and aligning closer with God's will. It is about learning to see with the eyes of faith, to touch with hands of service, and to love with a heart that reflects God's own. As we travel this path, we encounter various terrains, valleys of doubt, mountains of challenge, and meadows of peace. Each landscape provides its lessons and opportunities to grow. We may face trials and tribulations, but these are the very experiences that shape and define our faith. They compel us to lean into God's strength and to rely on His guidance, fortifying our spirit for the journey ahead. Moreover, for those who have already embarked on this spiritual voyage, it is essential to recognize that the journey is not a solitary one. We are accompanied by a fellowship of believers, each with their own compass, their own unique relationship with God, yet all moving in the same direction towards a collective horizon of faith and understanding. The compass, therefore, does not just point us to our destination, it also aligns us with our fellow travelers. It encourages us to support one another, to share in the burdens and joys, and to learn from the diverse ways in which God reveals Himself to each of us. In this shared journey, our individual growth contributes to the growth of the entire faith community. Let this be known, the spiritual journey is not a race to the finish, but a pilgrimage of purpose. We are encouraged to continue seeking God with the same passion as when we first believed, embracing every step with intention and gratitude. Each day presents a fresh opportunity for revelation and transformation, for drawing closer to God and becoming more like Him in thought, word, and deed. In this continuous journey, we are reminded that each step is significant, each moment ripe with potential. There is no plateau of spirituality from which we cannot ascend further. There is always a higher peak of understanding, a deeper well of wisdom, and a broader expanse of love to explore. Thus, we are called to persist in our spiritual endeavors, to press on with eager hearts, knowing that the path we walk is hallowed ground, sanctified by the countless steps of those who have walked before us and blessed by the presence of God who walks beside us. Let us renew our pursuit each day, mindful that the journey is as important as the destination, and every step is a step closer to the divine. The spiritual journey is not a future event to be scheduled, but a present reality to be lived. It calls us to recognize that the act of seeking God is bound neither by past regrets nor by future intentions. Instead, it is an ever-present imperative, as immediate and as vital as the air we breathe. The time to seek God is not tethered to the convenience of tomorrow, but is anchored firmly in the now, the only moment where true action and genuine change can occur. The present moment is uniquely ours to embrace, a gift that is continuously unwrapped as we live out each second. It is in these successive instances that we are invited to engage with the divine, to knock on the door of the spiritual realm, and to seek an audience with God. This immediacy is crucial. For while the past is unchangeable and the future is uncertain, the present holds the power of choice and the potential for transformation. Our spiritual compass points us towards God, and it demands that we follow it in real time. Attentive to the subtle whispers of the Spirit that guide us towards acts of kindness, moments of reflection, and decisions of faith. To postpone this pursuit is to ignore the insistent tug of the divine on our hearts, the quiet yet persistent call to deepen our connection with our Creator. Today, not tomorrow, is the day of salvation, the day to align our lives with God's will. It is a call to live out our faith actively and purposefully, to seek God with the urgency that the fleeting nature of life deserves. This present moment is the only one in which we can enact our faith, live out the commandments, and experience the presence of God. Tomorrow's uncertainties remind us that each current breath may be our last opportunity to seek and to serve. We are called to seek God with the same immediacy as the saints and prophets of old, who responded to God's call without hesitation. The biblical exhortation to seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near, Isaiah 55 verse 6, is not just poetic advice, it is a practical directive for spiritual living. It is an urgent call to weave God into the very fabric of our daily lives, making the pursuit of the divine an integral part of our every moment, and recognizing that the time to seek God is now. We also acknowledge that our spiritual journey is not a separate component of our lives, but the essence of our existence. It is not an activity to be relegated to the sidelines, but the central pursuit around which all other activities revolve. In the immediacy of today, we find the courage to live boldly for God, to express our faith in both word and deed, and to bear witness to the transformation that a life lived in God's presence can bring. The immediacy of seeking God in the present moment also speaks to the continuous nature of our spiritual development. Each moment is a step on the journey, a chance to grow closer to God and to be transformed by His love. It is a journey that does not wait for the right time, but creates it, turning each present moment into the perfect opportunity for spiritual growth and deeper communion. Therefore, let us seize the time that is right now, embracing the present as the divine appointment it is. Let us respond to our spiritual compass with promptness, knowing that in the act of seeking, we are already drawing closer to the heart of God. The time to seek God is not a distant tomorrow or in a future of convenience, but the time is right now. Let us step forward on this journey with open hearts and expectant spirits, trusting that as we draw closer to God, He will draw near to us, enriching our lives with His grace, peace, and immeasurable love. The spiritual imperative to seek God is not without its reasons. The call to action is underpinned by a multitude of compelling motivations, each serving as a beacon to illuminate our path closer to God's loving embrace and boundless grace. Here we delve into seven pivotal reasons that not only justify but necessitate our immediate turn towards God. 1. The fragility and uncertainty of life. just as the scripture in James 4 verse 14 compares life to a vapor, appearing for a little while and then vanishing. So too is our opportunity to seek God amidst the transient nature of our earthly journey. This fragility implores us to act without delay. To understand the brevity of our existence as a clarion call to spiritual action. 2. The promise of eternal life in the assurance of John 3 verse 16. We find a profound promise. Belief in God's only begotten Son offers not just a future hope, but a present reality of eternal life. This immediate access to a transformed life is a beacon calling us to seek the eternal over the ephemeral. 3. The transformative power of God's love. God's love, as demonstrated in Romans 5 verse 8, is a catalyst for profound change within us. It offers a path from brokenness to wholeness, from confusion to clarity. This transformative potential is a treasure we are urged to seek now, allowing God's love to reshape our lives. 4. The wisdom and guidance available in God. Proverbs 2 verse 6 tells us that wisdom is a divine gift. In a world rife with confusion, the clear, guiding wisdom from God is an indispensable resource we must seek earnestly and without delay. 5. The fulfillment and purpose found in God, the existential quest for purpose and fulfillment. As echoed in Ecclesiastes 3 verse 11, finds its answer in God. This search compels us to turn to our Creator, where true meaning and contentment can be discovered. 6. The need for spiritual strength in trying times, as Isaiah 40 verse 31 promises. Those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. This strength is not just for endurance, but for thriving amidst life's challenges. And it beckons us to seek its source now. 7. The assurance of God's provision and care. Matthew 6 verse 33 reassures us of God's provision when we seek His kingdom first. In the material uncertainty of our times, this assurance is a profound reason to seek God's providence and care immediately. Each reason is not merely a rationale, but a stepping stone that brings us nearer to God. They are not isolated truths, but interconnected revelations that, when pursued, weave a tapestry of a life lived in full communion with the divine. These reasons do not exist to instill fear, but to awaken desire, to ignite within us a passion for seeking God that is as relentless as it is reflective. The seven reasons collectively serve as a roadmap for our journey towards God. They're reminders, encouragements, and sometimes warnings that highlight the urgency of our spiritual seeking. They beckon us to look beyond the surface of our daily lives and to see the spiritual realities that underlie our existence. This journey towards God, illuminated by these seven reasons, is not a mere enhancement of our lives, but the very essence of living. It calls us to live not just in the moment, but for the moment of connection, of prayer, of communion with God. It is a journey of transformation that begins now and continues into eternity, with each reason reinforcing the call to seek God with immediacy, sincerity, and wholehearted devotion. As we explore these reasons, let them be more than abstract concepts. Let them be personal encounters that kindle within us a living flame, a desire to journey deeper into the heart of God where true treasures lie. Let these reasons inspire us to action, to live out our faith with urgency and purpose, and to embark on the greatest adventure, the journey into the presence of God. The first reason to seek God immediately lies in the profound truth about the nature of our existence, life's uncertainty. Scripture is clear in its message, for instance. James 4 verse 14 reminds us that our life is like a vapor, visible for a short time and then dissipating into the ether. This metaphor captures the ephemeral quality of our earthly sojourn and underscores the need for urgency in our spiritual endeavors. The fleeting nature of life serves as a constant reminder that we do not have the luxury of procrastination on our side. Just as a vapor appears momentarily and then vanishes, so too can the opportunities we have to deepen our relationship with God and to grow spiritually. The story of the rich fool in Luke 12 verses 16 to 21 starkly exemplifies this truth, the man's sudden death. Just as he planned to enjoy his earthly wealth, teaches us that material possessions and worldly plans are futile without a foundational relationship with God. The unpredictability of life means we can never be certain when our last chance to seek God will come. The sudden and unexpected nature of life's events, as illustrated in the parable of the 10 virgins in Matthew 25 verses 1 to 13, where 5 were unprepared for the bridegroom's arrival, highlights the importance of being spiritually ready at all times. Moreover, the urgency to seek God is further emphasized by the reality of our mortality. Hebrews 9 verse 27 reminds us that it is appointed for humans to die once, and after that comes judgment. This stark reality makes it clear that our earthly journey is limited and that the time to seek God is not at some indefinite point in the future, but now. While the opportunity is present and the spirit is willing. The story of King Hezekiah in 2 Kings 20 verses 1 to 6 further demonstrates the unpredictability and brevity of life. When Hezekiah was faced with the prophecy of his impending death, he turned to God in prayer, and his life was extended. This narrative not only highlights the uncertainty of our days, but also the power of turning to God in our moments of need. It is a compelling call to seek God's presence and favor while we still draw breath, while our hearts still beat with the rhythms of life. Thus, the first reason to seek God now is rooted in the reality that each moment is precious and unpredictable. We must live with the awareness that the time for spiritual action is always the present. Let this understanding ignite a sense of immediacy in our pursuit of God, encouraging us to embrace each day as a unique opportunity for spiritual awakening and to live in a way that honors the transience and sacredness of life. The second reason to seek God without delay is the promise of eternal life, a foundational tenet of Christian faith that extends an invitation of hope beyond the confines of our temporal existence. This promise, as articulated in one of the most well-known and cherished verses, John 3 verse 16, offers us a profound assurance that whoever believes in God's only begotten Son shall not perish but have everlasting life. It is this assurance that compels us to seek God in the here and now. For the promise of eternal life is not merely a distant future hope, but a transformative present reality. The immediacy of this promise is underscored by the account of the criminal on the cross in Luke 23 verses 39 to 43. In his final moments, the criminal, recognizing Jesus as Lord, was assured of his place in paradise that very day. This powerful instance reveals that it is never too late to turn to God, and that the promise of eternal life is instantly accessible to those who believe. Seeking God now opens the door to a life transformed by the hope and certainty of eternity with Him. In the New Testament, the Apostle Peter speaks to this immediate hope in 1 Peter 1 verses 3 to 4, describing it as a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, leading to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading. This inheritance is available to all who seek God and accept His gift of salvation. The promise of eternal life thus reorients our perspective on earthly struggles and challenges. As the Apostle Paul writes in 2 Corinthians 4 verse 17, our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. The story of Lazarus and the rich man in Luke 16 verses 19 to 31 presents a vivid contrast between the realities of heaven and hell, illustrating the eternal consequences of our earthly decisions to seek God or to ignore Him. The comfort Lazarus experiences in eternity versus the rich man's torment serves as a stark reminder of the critical importance of choosing to seek God now, while we have the chance. Therefore, the promise of eternal life is a beacon that illuminates our path and fuels our urgency to seek God. It reminds us that the choices we make in the present have everlasting implications. This promise encourages us to look beyond our temporal circumstances and to anchor our lives in the eternal. To prioritize our relationship with God as the most significant investment we can make, knowing that it yields eternal dividends. The second reason invites us to embrace the spiritual journey with a forward-looking vision, ensuring that our present walk with God is in step with the eternal life He has promised. It calls us to engage with our faith actively, to live out the principles of the gospel in our daily lives, and to do so with the knowledge that in God, we find not just the hope of life after death, but the joy of life before death, infused with His eternal presence. The third compelling reason to seek God immediately is the transformative power of His love. A central theme of the Christian faith and a potent force that reshapes our lives. This reason is encapsulated in Romans 5 verse 8, which declares, "But God demonstrates His own love for us in this, while we were still sinners, Christ died for us." The gravity of this statement reveals that the love of God is not passive or conditional, it is active and given freely, even to those who may feel unworthy. This divine love is the catalyst for profound personal transformation. It transcends human understanding and has the power to change hearts and lives. When we experience the depth of God's love as demonstrated through Christ's sacrifice, it has a profound effect on us. This transformation is not superficial, it is a deep inner reformation that alters the way we view ourselves, others, and the world around us. It calls us to repentance, to a new way of living that is aligned with God's will. The story of Zacchaeus in Luke 19 verses 1 to 10 is a clear illustration of this transformative power. Zacchaeus, a tax collector, was changed from a man reviled by his community into one who sought restitution and lived generously. His encounter with Jesus and the subsequent experience of God's love led to an immediate and visible change in his actions and priorities. Furthermore, God's love is not only transformative but also restorative. The narrative of the woman caught in adultery, as recounted in John 8 verses 1 to 11, shows how Jesus' love and forgiveness can free us from the bonds of sin and shame. This account exemplifies the non-condemning, restorative nature of God's love, a love that does not expose our faults to shame us, but to heal us. The transformative power of God's love also has the ability to instill new purpose and direction in our lives. The conversion of Saul to Paul in Acts 9 verses 1 to 19 is a prime example. Saul, originally a persecutor of Christians, became one of the most influential apostles, all because of an encounter with God's love on the road to Damascus. His transformation was so complete that it not only changed the course of his life, but also had a significant impact on the spread of early Christianity. Moreover, the love of God compels us to extend that love to others. As we experience the fullness of God's love, it naturally overflows from us and touches the lives of those we interact with. The early church, described in Acts 2 verses 42 to 47, exemplifies a community transformed by God's love, marked by fellowship, sharing, and caring for one another. God's love also provides comfort and reassurance in times of trouble. In the story of Job, despite his immense suffering, he experienced the faithfulness and love of God, which sustained him through his trials. The parable of the prodigal son in Luke 15 verses 11 to 32 beautifully illustrates the redemptive love of the father. Despite the son's rebellion and mistakes, the father welcomes him back with open arms, a reflection of how God's love is always ready to embrace and restore us when we turn back to him. Therefore, the third reason to seek God now is the potential for transformation that his love offers. It is an invitation to be renewed, to shed the old and to embrace the new creation that we become in Christ. This transformative love is not an abstract concept, but a living, active force that can begin to work in us the moment we turn to God. It is an imperative that compels us to seek God with sincerity, allowing his love to change us from the inside out and to live lives that are a testament to the power of his grace. The fourth reason to urgently seek God is the pursuit of divine wisdom and guidance. Proverbs 2 verse 6 tells us, "For the Lord gives wisdom, from his mouth come knowledge and understanding." This wisdom is not only for discernment and decision-making, but is also a guiding light through the complexities and challenges of life. In a world where truth can often seem obscured, and choices are many, the wisdom that comes from God provides clarity and direction, ensuring our paths align with his will. The story of King Solomon, as narrated in 1 Kings 3 verses 5 to 14, serves as a classic example of seeking and receiving wisdom from God. Solomon, when offered anything he desired, chose wisdom above riches, power, or long life. God granted him not only wisdom, but also the things he did not ask for: riches and honor among men. Solomon's request for wisdom resulted in a prosperous and impactful reign, setting a precedent for us to value divine wisdom above all in our personal and professional lives. The need for divine wisdom is ever present. Daniel and his friends, as described in Daniel 1 verses 8 to 20, chose to follow God's wisdom even in matters as seemingly mundane as their diet. As a result, they were healthier and more knowledgeable than their peers. Their story demonstrates that following God's wisdom can lead to practical benefits and favor. Moreover, God's guidance is crucial in navigating life's challenges. Joshua's story of leading the Israelites into the Promised Land, Book of Joshua, especially chapter 1, exemplifies how divine guidance leads to success. Joshua's reliance on God's instructions was key to overcoming the obstacles they faced in taking possession of the land promised to them. The New Testament also emphasizes the role of the Holy Spirit as a guide for believers. Jesus' promise of the Holy Spirit in John 16 verse 13 reassures us of a constant helper and guide. However, when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will guide you into all truth. This assurance is comforting, especially when we are faced with decisions that impact our lives and the lives of others. The wisdom of God brings peace and stability into our lives. As Paul writes in Philippians 4 verses 6 to 7, "The peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard our hearts and minds as we seek God through prayer and supplication." This peace is a direct result of seeking God and his wisdom, providing a solid foundation regardless of life's storms. Joseph's story. From his dreams to becoming the governor of Egypt, Genesis 37 to 50, showcases how divine wisdom and guidance can lead to extraordinary outcomes. Joseph's ability to interpret dreams and wisely manage Egypt's resources during a famine was a clear manifestation of God's wisdom at work. Therefore, the fourth reason to seek God now is the wisdom and guidance he offers to navigate life effectively. This wisdom is not only for our benefit, but also serves the greater good, allowing us to be instruments of God's will, positively impacting those around us and the broader society. Seeking God's wisdom and guidance is not a passive activity, but an active pursuit that requires our immediate attention and commitment. It is an invitation to live lives that are not only fulfilling and successful, but also aligned with the divine purpose and order. The fifth compelling reason to seek God now lies in the quest for true fulfillment and purpose. A quest that finds its ultimate resolution in a relationship with the Creator. Ecclesiastes 3 verse 11 states that God has made everything beautiful in its time. He has also set eternity in the human heart. This profound insight speaks to a deep-seated yearning within every individual for something more enduring than what the material world offers. It is a yearning that can only be satisfied in God. Our pursuit of fulfillment and purpose often leads us down various paths, with many seeking satisfaction in wealth, pleasure, accomplishments, or human relationships. However, as King Solomon illustrates in the book of Ecclesiastes, particularly in chapters 1 and 2, these pursuits, while not inherently bad, are ultimately unfulfilling without a central relationship with God. True fulfillment and purpose are found not in the transient things of this world, but in the eternal nature of God. The story of Moses, as depicted in the book of Exodus, is a powerful testament to the fulfillment and purpose found in following God. From his royal upbringing in Egypt to leading the Israelites out of bondage, Moses' life was marked by a profound sense of purpose and direction, which he found in his obedience to God's call. This journey from prince to prophet demonstrates that true fulfillment comes from embracing God's plan for our lives. Furthermore, a relationship with God fills the existential void that worldly pleasures cannot. The story of the woman at the well, John 4 verses 1 to 26, exemplifies this. Her encounter with Jesus and his offer of living water transformed her life, filling her with a sense of purpose and belonging that she had not found in her previous encounters. In seeking God, we also discover our unique role in his grand design. Each believer has a part to play in God's kingdom. As seen in the diverse roles and ministries of the apostles and early Christians in the New Testament, the book of Acts, especially chapters 2 to 4, highlights how each believer, filled with the Holy Spirit, contributed to the growth and impact of the early church. Moreover, in God, we find the courage and strength to pursue our God-given dreams and aspirations. The story of Nehemiah rebuilding the walls of Jerusalem, as told in the book of Nehemiah, is an inspiring example of accomplishing great things when aligned with God's purpose. Nehemiah's dedication and perseverance in the face of opposition highlight that with God, no dream is too big, and no obstacle is insurmountable. The fulfillment and purpose found in God are everlasting. Unlike worldly pursuits that can fade or lose their luster over time, as we walk with God, the purpose and fulfillment derived from this relationship deepen and become more satisfying. Therefore, the fifth reason to seek God now is to discover the deep fulfillment and purpose that only He can provide. It is an invitation to live a life that is not only rich in earthly experiences, but also anchored in eternal truth and significance. This pursuit of God for fulfillment and purpose is not just a journey towards something. It is a journey with someone, where every step brings us closer to the heart of our Creator and the true essence of our existence. The sixth pivotal reason to seek God now is the indispensable need for spiritual strength. Especially in the face of life's trials and tribulations, Isaiah 40 verse 31 offers a profound promise, "But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint." This scripture encapsulates the sustaining power of relying on God during challenging times. In our human experience, It's inevitable that we encounter periods of hardship, despair, and exhaustion, our own strength. In these instances, often proves insufficient. The psalmist in Psalm 121 lifts his eyes to the hills and finds his help in the Lord. A powerful testament to the fact that our true strength comes from God. This reliance on the divine in times of weakness is not a sign of defeat, but an acknowledgement of the vast reservoir of strength and support that God offers. The story of Elijah in 1 Kings 19 verses 1-8 poignantly illustrates the rejuvenating power of seeking God. After a great victory, Elijah faced fear and exhaustion. However, when he turned to God, he was strengthened and sustained for a 40-day journey to Horeb. This narrative demonstrates that when we feel overwhelmed and depleted, God is our source of strength and sustenance. In the New Testament, the Apostle Paul speaks about finding strength in weakness. In 2 Corinthians 12 verses 9-10, he discusses how God's power is made perfect in our weakness. This paradoxical truth reveals that in our most vulnerable moments, when we earnestly seek God, His strength is manifested in us, enabling us to endure and even thrive amidst difficulties. The early Christian martyrs, facing severe persecution, also exemplify the strength that comes from seeking God. Their stories, as recounted in the book of Acts and historical accounts, show that despite facing immense trials and even death, these believers found extraordinary strength and courage through their faith in God. Thus, the sixth reason to seek God without delay is our need for spiritual fortitude, a strength that surpasses human capacity and is found in the presence of the Almighty. This strength is not only for enduring hardships, but also for overcoming them and emerging with a deeper faith and a more profound understanding of God's faithfulness. In seeking God for strength, we are reminded that we are not alone in our struggles. The promise of God's enduring presence and unwavering support offers a wellspring of hope and resilience. It encourages us to face our trials not with fear or despair, but with confidence and peace, knowing that the Almighty God is with us, fortifying our spirit and guiding our steps. Therefore, in every challenge, in every moment of weakness, let us turn to God with faith and expectation, seeking His strength to renew us, to lift us up like eagle's wings, and to enable us to journey through life with endurance, grace, and courage. The time to seek this strength is now. For in doing so, we prepare ourselves to face whatever trials may come with the assurance of God's unfailing presence and power. The seventh and final reason to seek God immediately is grounded in the assurance of His provision and care. As highlighted in Matthew 6 verse 33, "But seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." This promise stands as a testament to God's faithfulness in meeting our needs when we prioritize our spiritual journey and relationship with Him. In a world often gripped by anxiety over material needs and future uncertainties, this assurance from God emerges as a beacon of hope and stability. The narrative of the Israelites in the wilderness, particularly in Exodus 16 with the provision of manna, showcases God's faithful provision. Despite their doubts and complaints, God provided for their daily necessities, teaching us a valuable lesson. When we place our trust in God and seek Him wholeheartedly, our basic needs are taken care of. Jesus' teachings on worry and reliance on God, as found in Matthew 6 verses 25-34, offer profound insights into God's caring nature. He points to the birds of the air and the lilies of the field, which do not toil yet are provided for by God. This analogy serves as a gentle yet powerful reminder that our Heavenly Father is acutely aware of our needs and is committed to providing for us. The story of Elijah and the widow of Zarephath in 1 Kings 17 verses 8 to 16 is another powerful testament to God's provision. In a time of famine, both Elijah and the widow experienced God's miraculous provision, affirming the principle that when we put our trust in Him, He provides in ways that often surpass our understanding. In the New Testament, the miracle of feeding the 5,000, as told in all four Gospels, e.g., Matthew 14 verses 13 to 21, further illustrates God's ability to provide abundantly. With just 5 loaves and 2 fish, Jesus fed a multitude, demonstrating that when we bring our limited resources to God, He can multiply them to meet not just our needs, but also the needs of others. The principle of sowing and reaping, as discussed in 2 Corinthians 9 verses 6 to 8, emphasizes that God is able to make all grace abound toward us. When we seek God and live in obedience to His principles, we position ourselves to experience His provision and blessings in every area of our lives. Therefore, the seventh reason to seek God now is to experience the full measure of His provision and care in our lives. This reason calls us to a life of faith and trust, where our primary pursuit is the kingdom of God and His righteousness, with the assurance that our earthly needs will not be neglected. It invites us to live in a state of spiritual awareness, recognizing that our daily provisions are not just material transactions, but expressions of God's love and care for us. In embracing this reason, we are encouraged to develop a mindset of dependence and gratitude, where our first response to life's needs and challenges is to turn to God in prayer and trust. It is a call to understand that our security and well-being are not ultimately determined by worldly standards, but are anchored in the unfailing nature of God's character and His promises to us. As we continue to seek God with urgency and sincerity, let these 7 reasons serve as guiding lights on our path, drawing us closer to the heart of God, where we find true satisfaction, peace, and fulfillment. Each reason reinforces the truth that seeking God is the most rewarding journey we can embark on, providing us with strength, wisdom, and assurance in every aspect of our lives. As we reflect on the 7 compelling reasons to seek God immediately, we arrive at a crucial juncture in our spiritual journey. This conclusion is not merely the end of a list, but the beginning of a deeper, more meaningful relationship with our Creator. The call to seek God is an invitation to a life-transforming adventure, one that promises not only eternal significance, but also profound impact on our daily living. This call to seek God is a clarion call to action. It is an urging to integrate our faith into every aspect of our lives, making our relationship with God the cornerstone upon which all other things are built. It's a reminder that our spiritual pursuit is not a periodic or occasional endeavor, but a continuous and integral part of our existence. The pursuit of God is marked by urgency and sincerity, driven by the recognition that our time here is limited and that every moment presents an opportunity to draw closer to Him. It's about seizing the present, living each day with the awareness that our actions, thoughts, and decisions are steps on the path towards or away from God. This journey towards God is not a solitary path. We are accompanied by a great cloud of witnesses, those who have walked this path before us and those who walk alongside us. Together, we navigate the complexities of life, encouraged and strengthened by each other's faith and experiences. The call to seek God is also a call to transformation. It's an invitation to be renewed in our minds, to let go of old patterns, and to embrace a new way of living that reflects God's love and righteousness. This transformation is both personal and communal, affecting not only our lives but also those around us. In this journey, we are not left to our own devices. God, in His grace, has provided us with His Word, His Spirit, and His community to guide, empower, and support us. The Holy Scriptures serve as a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. The Holy Spirit as our counselor and guide, and the community of believers as our support and encouragement. Therefore, let us step forward on this journey with open hearts and expectant spirits. Let us trust that as we draw closer to God, He will draw near to us, enriching our lives with His grace, peace, and immeasurable love. The time to seek God is not a distant tomorrow or a future of convenience, but is right now. This conclusion is not the end, but a new beginning, a fresh start in our walk with God. Let us embrace it with joy and anticipation, knowing that each step we take is a step closer to the heart of God, a step into a deeper understanding of His will, and a step towards a life filled with His presence and power. #14. Closing prayer. As we culminate our exploration of the compelling reasons to seek God, it is fitting to conclude with a moment of prayer, a powerful and intimate communication with our Heavenly Father. This prayer is an opportunity to collectively and personally affirm our commitment to the journey of seeking God, to express our gratitude, to seek forgiveness and guidance, and to implore His blessings upon our lives and the lives of others. Let us now join our hearts and voices in this prayer. #A prayer for guidance, strength, and blessings. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, Creator of heaven and earth, we come before You with hearts full of gratitude and awe. We exalt Your holy name, for You are the King of kings and the Lord of lords, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Your majesty and glory surpass all understanding. Your power is unmatched, and Your love knows no bounds. We worship You, O Lord, for You alone are worthy of all praise and adoration. Lord, we thank You for the countless blessings You have poured into our lives and the lives of our loved ones. We are grateful for Your unwavering love, Your boundless grace, and Your endless mercies that are new every morning. Thank You for the gift of life, for the air we breathe, and for the hope that is found in You. We thank You for the salvation You have provided through Your Son, Jesus Christ. As we approach Your throne of grace, we come seeking forgiveness. Forgive us, Lord, for the times we have fallen short of Your glory, for the moments we have strayed from Your path, and for the instances where our actions, words, and thoughts have not reflected Your love and righteousness. In Your mercy, wash us clean of our transgressions and renew our spirits, that we may walk in Your ways and live lives that honor You. We extend forgiveness to those who have wronged us, releasing any bitterness or resentment. For You, Lord, have taught us to love and forgive. Deliver us from all evil and lead us away from temptation. In the mighty name of Jesus, we declare that no weapon formed against us shall prosper. We rebuke the attacks of the enemy against us and declare his plans and schemes nullified in the name of Jesus. Lord, You are our Jehovah Rapha, our healer. We pray for healing to permeate every cell of our bodies and our minds. We pray against any form of the enemy's attacks against our minds, bodies, spirits, or relationships. We ask for your shield of protection to surround us and our loved ones. As we say this prayer, we are grateful for every heart that is opening before you right now. Together, we stand united in our faith as we lift each other in prayer. We seek your face with urgency, knowing that the time is now for us to draw near to you. Guide us, Lord, and instill in us a spirit of wisdom, understanding, and knowledge. Help us to seek you continually, to build our lives on the firm foundation of your word, and to pursue your heart with unwavering faith. We claim victory over our lives in your name. We declare healing in every area that needs your healing touch. We give thanks for your unending protection. May your Holy Spirit guide us, fill us, and use us for your glory as we commit to seeking you now with all that we are. Lord, let your kingdom come on earth and in our lives as it is in heaven. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Thank you, Lord, for hearing and answering our prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Let us carry the spirit of this prayer in our hearts as we go forth. May we remain open to the continual guidance and presence of God in our lives. Let us also encourage one another, building each other up in faith and love. As we journey together in pursuit of God's heart, let this prayer be a catalyst for deeper communion with God and a reminder of His ever-present love and faithfulness in our lives. Type, I am open to divine guidance in my life. May God come and guide me and my family each day. If this prayer resonates with you, share this video with your loved ones. Help us reach more souls and spread the gospel. Your support is cherished. You are blessed to be a blessing.